Hello, friends. I'm East Coast Pete. Welcome to my show without a name. Today I'm looking at Jackie Lomax. He was born in 1944 and he died in 2013. He was an English singer, songwriter, guitarist. And this is George Harrison's friend. And Harrison produced Lomax at Apple Records. Born in Cheshire, sort of on the outer rib, down in the West, early bands were Dee and the Dynamites, The Undertakers, The Lomax Alliance, Heavy Jelly, and Badger. Lomax spent 2 years in the U.S. with the Britbeat group The Undertakers. Brian Epstein brought Lomax back and signed him to CBS just before his death. There were three singles and enough stuffing for an album, but it was not released as such. After Epstein's death, the Beatles formed Apple and took over Lomax's contract. His next single, the Harrison song Sour Milk Sea, had little commercial success. Harrison and Lomax finished the tracks for Is This What You Want in Los Angeles with Hal Blaine and others from the Wrecking Crew. The album went early in 69, but still no success. A last Apple single, How the Web Was Woven, featuring Leon Russell, looked ready to take off, but the Beatles' breakup left Apple in shambles and Lomax in limbo. Also in limbo were Pete Ham and Tom Evans of Badfinger. They sang on Lomax's Heavy Jelly album, but it could not be released due to the turmoil at Apple. The Apple was released, but only after Lomax had died in 2013. In 1971, Lomax set up shop in Woodstock, New York. He signed with Warner with members of the Lomax Alliance and the Undertakers. Home Is In My Head and Three did not sell. Lomax went back to Britain a second time and he joined Badger, a prog band with Tony Kaye of Yes. White Lady was the album on Epic, and prog was now R&B, and Lomax went back to the U.S. to sign with Capitol in 1975. Livin' for Lovin' and Did You Ever Have That Feeling, Lomax left Capitol. The album was only released in the U.K. In the 80s, he played with the Teabags, a group of Brits misplaced in L.A., including Mick Taylor, Brian Auger, Terry Reid, Peter Banks, and others. He also played bass for the Drifters, the Diamonds, and the Coasters, and later with Tom Petty, Gene Clark, P.F. Sloan, John Stewart, and Lucinda Williams. Lomax recorded his first solo album since 1977, The Ballad of Liverpool Slim, in 2002. He would return to Liverpool several times to appear at the Cavern, where he had begun 40 years previous. And he still had some fans there. Cool. Now I'm going to look up that Sour Milk song, because I don't recall it in my mind right now, at this moment. Do you remember hearing that? I don't. Where is it? Come on, Jackie. There we go. No, that's a live one. I want to. No, that's a tribute. Here we go. Oh yeah. This sounds like the Beatles for sure. Around the White Album period. Holly, do you like Jackie Lomax? No. I find that cats are not musically critical.